3 words to describe STEM education. Wow. Blimey. And core. That's very cockney. But
I was going to say, are we going to get technical? Are they really words?
No. Exclamations.
Yeah. Yeah. All right. Can you explain STEM education in 20 seconds?
20 seconds.
We're starting with the big ones, okay?
No. It's too complicated.
Quality STEM education is about quality teaching and quality learning.
STEM education is like different sets of lenses on science, technology, engineering, and mathematics.
And applying it deeply to other scenarios and problem solving authentic problems about our world.
Shifting the perceptions of what engineering and what science, technology and maths is.
In useful and relevant and meaningful ways.
Is that 20?
Enabling children to learn the problem solving skills that are required to build a better future.
Yeah. What she said. Good answer. I like that.
Your turn.
Now.
Isn't STEM just what teachers have always done with a new name?
Good question. Mm. Because often, and you probably would agree, most teachers are not the same. So some will see STEM as something very new and not think about the kinds of practices that they've done forever. And others will go, this is interesting. This is a new way of thinking about things that I've done for quite some time.
There's actually elements of STEM that have always been done in the classroom. But now I think that it's really getting teachers to think in a different way and think a bit more creatively about how they engage students.
I think STEM brings a deeper focus to authentic problem solving and looking at collaboration and critical thinking and some of those more essential skills that perhaps we don't always do.
It's about getting kids being creative and solving real problems and,
in the world.
And whether you call it STEM or not, it doesn't really matter as it all fits in there, I think, so.
Perfect.
Okay. What drives you crazy when it comes to STEM education?
Okay, the thing... the one thing that I notice with teachers is that fact that they don't even bother to try STEM because they think it's going to be an addition to what they're doing already. And I think as soon as you start... or stop thinking of STEM as an add-on and start thinking of it as an add-in to your curriculum and enriching your curriculum, then teachers can feel a lot more comfortable about how they easily get it into their day-to-day teaching.
The one thing that really drives me wild, and it seems like a small thing, but when educators and when teachers or people who are experts in a certain field, they say, of course this, of course that. No, not of course. Assume people don't know anything, because then you're bringing them into that world, you're bringing them into that subject that you're teaching them.
Well, what annoys me, I would say, when it comes to STEM education, not everyone is engaged. You know, we see up to year 12, so few girls in particular engaging with the physical sciences, with mathematics. That's incredibly worrying, and it's down to the fact that it's not made interesting for everyone.
I think when people just think it's hard, when teachers don't really want to give it a go because they think, oh, I don't really know that.
It's not rocket science.
It's not rocket science. No. If I can do it, anyone can.
Well, it is rocket science.
Yeah.
I have a long list of things that drive me crazy. So it's great that we're having STEM as a conversation. That wasn't a word 7 years ago when I started working in this space. But I think we need to do more to shift those perceptions and have students not say things like, I'm just not a maths person. They don't say, I'm just not an English person. It's there's still those stereotypes there that we need to shift.
For you.
Can STEM education save the world?
Yeah, education can save the world.
So we can solve the world's big problems. We've got a few of them right now.
We've got a lot of big problems.
And they need STEM skills to solve them.
It's a bit like the, world peace question. Mm-hmm. Can STEM education save the world? No, humans can save the world. How they go about doing it, though, will rely on what they know, understand and can do. And so STEM is part of that.
There's so many challenges that we're facing, from climate change, you know, we've had the recent bushfires in Australia, flooding. These are all STEM problems.
That's a big question.
That's a big question.
So you better answer it, because you deal with big things.
Yes. I think it would have a very good influence on saving the world. We have a lot of big problems in the world at the moment, especially with climate change, and coming through science, technology, engineering and mathematics will all work to help us solve these big world problems.
I think for me, STEM education, it's the empathy that's important. And if we can get students to have an empathetic worldview, where they are thinking about all the problems that we are going to be facing now and into the future, then hopefully then we can build those problem solvers we're going to need.